Welcome, Delphi friends, to another episode, or I should say, video tutorial series from How It Works with Holger. This series will be about routing instructions on the web. And routing means, in this case, that you're not only going to ask a component like the TWeb Google Map component that comes with TMS Web Core to draw a route from A to B where you provide the coordinates or the address. No, you want precise driving instructions or bike instructions, walking instructions with distance, duration, and additional information depending on the routing provider or the mapping provider that you use. You might think, Holger, you've written a book about FNC maps and you claim these FNC components work on VCL, FireMonkey, and the web. That is most certainly true. However, if you read the documentation for the directions component from the FNC mapping framework, because of technical implications, it is not possible to use the API that is required to get the specific information for duration and also for distance. Basically, the driving instructions are not accessible from the web. However, this also gives you one good opportunity to implement something that I realized while doing this example. So let's look at the example first, and then you can judge if this tutorial is for you. I'm quite sure it will be, because it will provide a solution that you can easily adapt to your own requirements, for your own mapping requirements that you might have for your applications that are either other VCL applications that you want to hook up with a web service or a web application. So in a nutshell, two central parts will be built, a web application and a web service backend. Let me show you the web client first, how it works. Of course, I have to start the web services so that it works at all. Without a web service, I can't run the web client accessing the service, obviously. So I start the web application, start the web service. So it starts right away up in the browser, and I added two default addresses. Obviously, in production, I would remove those. And I want to go from Barefoot Beach and Bonita Springs to the Dali Museum in Tampa. So I click Get Directions. And the first thing that is very, very important to point out in this example, this map does not cost me anything. No fees, no subscription fees, because it's Leaflet, which is based on OpenStreetMap. Also, I don't have to include any API keys or anything in my web application. So this is what I realized when I was building this example, that I completely can abstract from paid Google services that I use in order to retrieve the route. So the server is going to use Google services, and the server has the API key for Google. Obviously, sharing this on a web application or inside your web application is a security aspect you always have to consider, meaning that you have to protect your API key, that it can only be used from your web server. That's the way you can protect it. However, that still doesn't protect you from somebody using your service excessively, so you would have to introduce more measures to prevent that from happening. This solution, however, with the backend, prevents this all, because there is no API key that anybody else can steal from your web page. Everything is neatly stashed away on the backend. The driving instructions will be neatly presented in this table. It has hover functionality, and the HTML that is returned from Google is directly being shown. So there's no work involved to get the nice boldface and all these things. So the key thing is that with the standard component from TMS Web Core, you would have a Google map, which would require a Google API key. And also, an additional thing is you would only be able to draw this line, but you would not be able to extract this. And even with FNC maps, you can only do it in VCL or FireMonkey applications. And this approach that I show here with the web service backend, this is an Xdata server VCL application, you can present these things in your web application, obviously. And you might wonder, why does Holger do a tutorial? Because it's like, Holger has done things like this a million times. He has a web client, and the web client sends origin, destination, and then provides the directions. I was just as optimistic in the beginning that it wouldn't be difficult. But as it turns out quite often when we develop software, there were some hurdles I had to take, and just as a sign of approval, I checked with the engineer from TMSX Data that everything I present to you here is sound with his implementation of TMSX Data. So this is the approach that is recommended by the team that developed XData. So I'm not presenting anything that is cutting corners or that is a hack. No, this is actually the solution that should be provided. Looking at the web application, how it works at the core, and let's tinker a little bit before we get into the code. When we press F12, we can look at this application through the developer console, and there is not much going on. If I basically restart the application, I don't see anything on the console, but if I go to the network tab, these are all the different map tile. So if you click on here and look what it shows, these are all the different tile from the map. And that's, if you move the map, I would assume there's going to be more tile being added right here. So that is a functionality fully automatic. You don't have to deal with any of it. However, what is your programming is the index page. That's the landing page of your TMS Web Core application. That's the file that the Delphi IDE always asks you to save in addition to your main form and the project file if you create a new project. This is the actual application because TMS Web Core files are converted to JavaScript. And this is the Bootstrap, which is downloaded from a content delivery network, meaning if you're located in Europe, you probably downloaded from a different server than me being located in the United States right now. Bootstrap icons is another CSS style sheet set that gives me these icons in the table. I'll show you real quick. As soon as I click here, I generate the directions, and you see here these icons right here. Those are Bootstrap icons that we can easily use. I'll show them when we generate the table. I go a little bit deeper into Bootstrap icons. And on the network tab, I can find the web service call. So I call, and I go into the header for that. I call my web service right here. And you might wonder, HTTPS beta 1. Well, I'm running this server here on my local machine. However, it is available on the internet. I always use a proxy to make that happen. I also have a video in this very TMS TV YouTube feed, how you can quickly publish your web application endpoints or web service endpoints. If you don't have a proxy available, you can get one really, really easy. Go to ngrok. That provides your web applications with HTTPS without any service that you need. However, I recommend using Docker, for example, to create your deployment scenarios really quickly with HTTPS, with certificates, to really have a testing environment that more or less resembles the real use case later on. In my book, TMS, about TMS Web Core, I present a detailed solution how you can do that. So looking at the header again, it's a post call. We're not going to use any XData specific components on the web client. That's intentional. There is no requirement for XData specific components on the client. XData maps everything to HTTP or HTTPS. So that's the reason why you can use it from any other programming language without any additional work. The XData components that you can drop on the form or your data module in TMS Web Core just make it easier under certain circumstances. In this case, we only have to do one call to the backend in order to retrieve the direction. So it doesn't really matter if I use the XData components or if I do the post request myself and passing all the parameters. You'll see it's quite easy with TMS Webcore. Still using components, we're just going to use a normal general HTTP request component. The parameters here, the payload, that's what makes it interesting. This is where we put the destination and the origin and send it to the backend, and then we get the response. This is what the response looks like with one route, with many, many steps, and then each step has a distance, a duration, instructions, and most important of all, coordinates. This will allow us to draw the line and also determine where the starting point is and where the end point is. All in all, this is a well-rounded TMS Web Core project that will be interesting to look at for your own projects, because aside from all the mapping that I will show, you will also learn about using Bootstrap again, how to arrange your button next to the form elements here, how to embed a FNC component inside of a Bootstrap grid layout, and then how to dynamically create this table, because when I start this application, there is no table. Right here, there's only a line. I let this line in intentionally so we can see that the line or that the table is already there. If we look at the source of the page right here, if we point to it right here, there we go. We see that I have a div element defined, but there is nothing in there. There's only a hook table, whatever that means. But it's as it says, it's a hook for me into my HTML, and then I can generate the table into that HTML space, and I'm going to use Delphi code or Object Pascal code for that. So we're not going to write any JavaScript. None of the project contains any JavaScript. We're going to use Delphi code. We're going to use classes and objects. Everything will be typely saved. So all mistakes you could potentially make will be caught at compile time. Even the JSON parsing could get caught at compile time if you add additional classes for the names of your attributes. I didn't do this, but this project is a pretty good use case how you can build a client for an Xdata project without using Xdata components and then generating dynamic data on the web client side. So without further ado, in the next part, we'll finally start coding. Just a heads up with regards to the scope of this video tutorial. I won't be able to explain the basics of TMS Web Core, TMS Xdata. I'm going to present an example. I'm going to do my best that it is accessible if you're interested in the technology, but I don't expect you to be able to write the code that I'm showing to you in this tutorial yourself by just watching this video and applying it to other use cases without doing some additional learning with other resources. Obviously, other resources could be my book, Web Application Development with Delphi, that features everything you need to know about TMS Web Core. It has been re-released in 2023 with a second edition in English. It's now roughly 800 pages, and you even get an introduction to Xdata, and deployment is featured in the second edition, deployment on Linux, deployment with certain web providers, and also deployment with Docker, which makes it really, really interesting if you want to set up your real-world usage scenario at home without spending a lot of money on hardware. So that might be interesting to you. Furthermore, with regards to Xdata, there's also this book, the Multi-Tier Cross-Platform Data Access. However, if you really want to get into Xdata and learn all the basics and also be able to build an Xdata server that has logging, runs as a Windows service, basically learn Xdata from the ground up, then this TMS Web Services with TMS Xdata video course tutorial, it's about 14 hours of content with source code. It is accessible by going to, as any other resource that you see here, my books and courses, go to holgerscode.com, and from there you either click on books and courses, and this will be updated on a regular basis. The news is also, or might be, interesting for you because I post all my upcoming content as well as the content that I publish for TMS with regards to new releases on the blog, and also other interesting DeFi news. So have a look at that page, or even if you go to the homepage, there is an RSS feed that you can subscribe to, just like in the good old days, right? Nobody uses RSS anymore, so I still give you the option to have RSS, but I also post to Twitter X, Threads, those are the platforms that I try, and LinkedIn, those are the platforms that I try to keep up to date with new content that shows up on Holger's Code. But now finally, let's get to coding.